shine.
Let me ask you a question. I was watching TV the other day, and they were talking about relationships and sex and all of that. And they're saying about ways to spice up your love life, like what gets you aroused, like what makes you like all feeling erotic and, you know, in the mood. And they're talking about bringing in outside things, you know, whether it's toys or pornos or things like that. Is that something you've ever done? I mean, I kind of want to, but I don't know. I wouldn't know how to introduce that to my partner.
Well, is that something he would be interested in, or is there like a level of being uncomfortable that you would have with it?
I think he'd be okay with it because I know he's watched porn, of course, you know, to, you know, do whatever he has to do. And I know I have a couple movies of my own at home, and yeah. I have my toys, you know, but I've never, that's been something I've always used for myself, you know, and I've never thought to involve my partner in that. And I mean, have you done that? I don't know.
I mean, there's been times. I don't like to rely on any one thing way too much, though, I think. Yeah. I think that it should be like a spice. I think sometimes if you rely on like say eroticism, I think mm-hmm. if you rely on like hardcore eroticism, you sort of get numb after a while mm-hmm. to being with one another. So yeah. I think, I don't know. I mean, my opinion is it should be sort of on special occasions, but yeah. I know that not everyone feels that way. I know a lot of people sort of go hardcore yeah. and try to always have, you know, something that excites them maybe a little bit more and a little bit more.
I would like to have my partner and I feel erotic together, you know, and, you know, maybe using sense of touch and lotions and things like that to get him aroused and have me get aroused to heighten that level of, you know, sexuality and, you know, orgasm at some point. I'd rather use those kind of methods, I think, you know, to develop that eroticism for me.
Rather than like to watch
rather
like
than
a
to
video
bring in an outside okay. product. I think that would be a better steering point for me to get that level of eroticism going in the bedroom for me.
Yeah. Well, that just depends too. I mean, I heard that men are more visual. So a lot of times I think maybe that's why men are attracted to porn, because it's more of a visual stimulation.
Yeah.
And where women maybe, you know, maybe it's more touch and the pleasure of.
And I wonder where that comes from, like this whole theory of what's erotic for a man versus what's erotic for a woman. Women tend to like touch and sensuality and that kind of loving affection, whereas men seem to like what's more visual. So I wonder how to get them more aroused in those situations. Do I just need to stand there in lingerie and then they get aroused? Or I think that wouldn't prolong the, you know, or heighten, you know, their desire, their feeling at the end. So I haven't done any research on that. I think I should.
I also heard that women tend to like get aroused more at reading. Like women will read more of like the romance books where they don't see like the smut, but they read the smut. They, you know.
Yeah, that's true. I read plenty of those books myself. But yeah, I don't necessarily go to like pornographic magazines where maybe a guy will. And I assume girls do too. They have, you know, the magazines for men.
Absolutely.
You know, with men in them, I mean.
Uh-huh.
You know, they have them for men, they have them for women. But yeah, I think that might be true. Women like more the fantasy field, you know, the illusion of arousal, you know, whether it's through wearing lingerie or a touch or sensation or reading it in a book and reading the words.
Yes.
And then getting, you know, that heightened feeling from that. So.
Well, and I think they can, like you say, it's more of a fantasy, and they can more put it into their vision rather than to, because I know the first time I saw like a hardcore porno, I sort of got sick to my stomach. I mean, it's not pretty.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? It's where if you're reading about, you know, the lady who takes the man and they're like, you know, on the sailing the seven seas, that's kind of romantic, and you can sort of make it erotic in your head, but when it's just all laying out there, I mean, you know, especially like when you're really young, you're like, oh my God, what to who?
Yeah, you know? I think you kind of have to baby step into what is sexual, what is erotic for you. You kind of start when you're, you know, in your teenage years watching, you know, the R-rated movies on cable and seeing the boobies and, you know, going from there and then maybe sneaking dad's magazine from under his bed kind of thing. And I think you start from there and you kind of work your way up to what makes you more aroused and having that erotic feeling. and wanting to incorporate that into a relationship.
Well, even the R-rated movies, they sort of make it, they romanticize it, they make it sexy, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? That's yeah. different from like a hardcore porno where yeah. it's just lying out there,
yeah.
you know? And so I think you're right, you almost have to baby step into that.
Yeah, because I don't know too many teenagers who will actually jump and push in, you know, put in the porno in the... in the player before they actually watch those late night cable movies that kind of yeah. jump starts that, you know, desire to see some of that stuff.
Yeah. And so. Then it also depends if they just stumble across it. Cause I think
yeah,
in this day and age, you know, used to be magazines, but I mean yeah. now everything is all on the computer. So, I mean, unless you've got your computer really locked up, I mean, even that, kids are so smart with the computer.
Oh, yeah, and it's either, do you want to block it? Yes, no. You can click no, and you can see it online. Yeah. But, yeah, I remember just watching that show, and I was thinking, you know, what can keep my partner satisfied? I want to just heighten that feeling. I want to make our time together more erotic, more sexual, and more orgasmic and everything. And, you know, I don't know if I want to bring in those outside things. I think I like just the idea, and I guess maybe... because I did watch those late night movies, but I never really got into watching porno all that much, although I have a few, but it was never a big thing for me. So yeah. I've always had my impression of being really erotic or sexual has been more of the romanticized feeling yeah. with the touch and the lingerie and things like that. So.
Yeah. Well, as long as like you and your boyfriend or, you know, your partner see eye to eye on it, I think you get in trouble where like one person might really want to go out there and the other yeah. person doesn't. They want to have like the romance and the romanticism, and they're not wanting to
yeah.
to get maybe as crazy. And so,
and I think that happens probably in a lot of, you know, couples situations where everyone's perception of what's erotic is different, because I'm sure for the guys a lot of it is porno, magazines, looking at the naked woman, all of that, that's what is erotic for them. Whereas a woman, it might be more the softer side of that. So mm-hmm. You're exactly right. You can probably get into a little bit of trouble if your ideas are not the same.
Well, I personally think with the computer, I mean, it used to be like eroticism wasn't one click away. I mean, eroticism was like truly like looking at your dad's magazines or getting a magazine mm-hmm. or sneaking into an R-rated movie.
Yeah.
I mean, now you can literally click it, and I think people tend to get desensitized. I actually yeah. heard that sometimes if you watch too much porn, you're actually not happy with your partner because there's wow. a level of eroticism that's almost too high. Like you can't
oh, wow.
you can't beat that high.
Gotcha.
So you almost wow. yeah, you almost have to, you know, like anything, take your eroticism in
yeah, portion. You have to cut it. Yeah, you have to
yeah.
wean yourself off.
Yeah, or don't yeah.
Eroticism Anonymous or something like that.
Yeah, because it's almost
cut the addiction.
Yeah, it's almost to the point like, you know, that doesn't excite me enough, so I want to go to the next level that excites me, you know. And then sometimes like a real life woman can't do what you see
exactly.
these people doing on the video screen.
Exactly. Yeah.
From the computer.
Huh. Well, that's interesting. I'm going to have to do a little research on that. I think people's idea of what is erotic is different. I think everyone should just formulate their own idea and impression on it. And as long as it's safe and it works for them and for their partner, I think it's a great thing.
Oh, absolutely. I agree. I mean, I think anything, as long as you're of age and it's a mutual response and everyone's happy in the relationship. I do remember the first time like I saw erotic images. It was my father's magazine.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and it was hardcore. It was like a Hustler, and it was in the bottom of this giant box, and I guess he thought he was being clever putting the magazines in the giant box, uh-huh. but I mean, it's a giant box. I mean, what more, you know, you might as well, what more can you do to tempt a kid? You might
exactly.
as well put marshmallows on top of it.
Oh, wow.
So I remember like finding it in the giant box, and but these were like hardcore, these were like Hustler, and this was like in the 1970s, so there was massive amounts of hair everywhere on these people.
Exactly.
I mean, a lot. And I remember it was, holy cow. And yeah. It was like a water scene. And I remember it was like near a pond. And I thought, oh, wow.
Has
that's...
this scarred you? You know this too detailed. Oh, goodness.
I still have the magazine.
No. Okay, yeah. Share it with your kids now.
And I remember I mean, there was like just mustaches and hair just hair, because it was the 70s, you know what I mean?
And that was the thing.
Then the hair on the top and the hair, just lots of hair. And yeah, I remember they were like by a lake or something, and then at one point the lady was on the tree. And that sort of seemed like sexy and romantic, but then like you get older and then you realize, yeah, you really shouldn't do that like on a tree. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, you get a rash from that.
Yeah, and then there's the oak poisoning. And, yeah,
you don't want to do that. I wonder why people's impression or image of eroticism has to be this hardcore image, like of porn and videos and, you know, having her legs spread wide open. Like, it shouldn't be that. It should be a little more of the basis of let's, you know, heighten that sexuality and enjoy each other's bodies. I think that's what eroticism should be. And I think that's what I've searched for when I've been reading the books and,
yeah,
you know, and yeah, I'll get the magazines to look at the pictures, but I'm also reading the articles too. And if I'm watching a porno, yeah, I'm looking at the images, but I'm also looking at what they're doing, what's working, what's making her feel good, what's making him feel good,
yeah,
so that feeling is heightened and better. So.
But you're right. I mean, it's probably a mutual story that everyone finds something hidden.
Yeah.
And so, like, if you're a kid and you realize, like, your parents are hiding stuff,
it's kind of taboo.
There's a bad or taboo,
yeah,
like almost altogether. So it's almost like passed on from generation to generation, like this dirty little secret.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, even you know, finding like your mom's like Harlequin romance and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, that's what it is.
You know?
All of the love novels she always read. She had tons of them, and I used to start reading those. But yeah, I just wish that word didn't have a negative image for some people, because it just really should be, you know, about the sexual act and enjoying yourself and your partner is kind of how I want it to be led towards. And that's what I've tried to do as an adult, is just learn about the art of having sex and feeling good and making that erotic event pleasurable for both people involved.
Yeah, absolutely. You know? Absolutely.
And that's what's worked for me.
Yeah.
So I don't necessarily want to bring in these outside images into the bedroom with me and my partner. It's like, I want to be the one to please him, not the movie or anything. I want to be the one to make him feel erotic or have him make me feel sexual and satisfying for him, and not the outside images. So
yeah.
That's why when I asked you earlier if you'd use any of that, and I know I have, but I don't necessarily want to, you know? So
yeah.
So I think it's something where if it works for you and if it works for your situation, then great. As long as you feel erotic and you feel sexual with your partner, I think that's where everybody should be happy in that situation.
I agree.